Elegy by Ralph Nazareth. With apologies to Zbigniew Herbert. Finally, when stock was taken and the account squared, it wasn't clear how much this young man really knew. He'd been less diligent than his buddy Horatio, stolid, entirely reliable, blessed with unfailing memory, constructing the world piece by syllogism in his mind, with no room for non-sequiturs. And never had the rough and tumble of the kid on the next block, 40 they called him, brash and brassy, but with a good heart, who later came to pick through the bloodied treasure of his Elsinore, fix the sewers, and unionize the prostitutes. He was mostly wrapped in a pale cast of thought, and with little Latin, less Greek, and not a word of Sanskrit, had skipped around whole constellations, Valmiki, Vyasa, Homer, Dante, Cervantes, Rabelais, Tolstoy, and, ah yes, Proust, and never had the patience or stomach to hear Molly B's soliloquize. So what story would his old friend tell the world? That this young prince, this heavy cloud, this lost soul, who had let slip through his desperate fingers the sweet, sad love of his delicate youth, had done nothing, 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 but merely looked into the heart of things, and had concluded, at best provisionally, a little something about the fall of sparrows, or the passage of kings through the guts of a beggar. And standing with his hands smudged with the death of stars, had faintly begun to see that readiness is all.